But if this is the person's primary love language, what it says to them is that you've got them on your heart. You've got them in your mind. You had to be thinking about them to get anything and bring it and give it to them. It's just, it makes them feel loved, just like words of affirmation makes another person feel loved. It's universal to give gifts as an expression of love. The gift says, they were thinking about me. Look what they got from me. The gift doesn't have to be expensive. We've always said it's the thought that counts. Mm-hmm. But I like to remind people, it's not the thought left in your head that counts. It's the gift that came out of the thought in your head. You know, I say to guys, you can get flowers free in the spring and summer. Mm-hmm. Just go out in your backyard and pick one. Mm-hmm. That's what your kids do. Mm-hmm. Most mothers have received a dandelion from their kids.
Yeah.
So just go out in your backyard. You don't have any flowers in your backyard? Check out your neighbor's yard. Ask them. Don't steal them. Ask them. academic background before I studied counseling and theology was anthropology. I did an undergrad and a master's in cultural anthropology, the study of cultures. Yeah. It's universal. There are no cultures where people don't give gifts as an expression of love. And for some people, this is very, very meaningful. And for other people, it's not on the top list.
So, for instance, has nothing to do with this. You could be in a marriage where if she's just a horrible person, has done something wrong, would bring you something, and you just want her to say you're sorry.
Yeah, well, that is a cultural phenomena in China. I learned this when I was in China, mm-hmm. that if they have wronged someone, one of the things they do is they go buy a gift and they give it to the person without saying anything, mm-hmm. because it's a shame culture. Mm-hmm. They don't want to have shame of having failed.
Right.
And if it works, it works, you know. But yeah. But I think it's not giving gifts to appease the other person. It's giving gifts because you love the other person and you know that this is meaningful to them. And it helps, obviously, if you know what they're interested in. You know, if they have a special candy bar and you go to the grocery store and you just bring home that candy bar and say, honey, I was thinking about you. That means a lot to them. If you know they collect certain things and you're traveling and you find something they're collecting and so meaningful gifts is you have to know the person to know what would be meaningful to them.
What is giving a gift really saying? Is it just that some people are wired that it couldn't be just that I want more stuff. What's a gift giving really saying to the person whose language is receiving gifts?
I think it's simply the fact that you had to think about me to do this.
Okay.
When we were away, you were thinking about me. Now, you know, we have traditions that kind of force us to give gifts during the Christmas time, on birthdays, on Valentine's Day, and that sort of thing. And we kind of just do that as a part of our culture. But if this is the person's primary love language, what it says to them is that you've got them on your heart. You've got them in your mind. You had to be thinking about them to get anything and bring it and give it to them. It's just, it makes them feel loved, just like words of affirmation makes another person feel loved. Mm-hmm.